In this video, I'm going to demonstrate where the gluteus maximus is and how to palpate. You know, gluteus maximum covers the pelvis and hip joint. It originates from basically iliac crest and sacrum, coccyx, and some ligaments. And it originates from the sacrotuberous ligaments right here. Actually, gluteus maximus has a lot of origins. That means if gluteus maximus gets tight, it can affect so many things. The one more thing before I start palpating, it crosses the sacroiliac joint. That's why if this muscle gets tight, it can also affect sacroiliac joint. This joint is very important for low back pain. So imagine gluteus maximus is covering like this and attaches on gluteal tuberosity on the femur. So I'm going to show you how to palpate on the real human. Now imagine this is iliac crest right here and this is sacrum. It's easy to palpate, right? Because iliac crest and sacrum are easy to palpate. You know, there are not much big muscles on the sacrum and iliac crest. It's like a L shape, right? Simplified version. So if you can palpate iliac crest, you can palpate gluteus maximus. And gluteus maximus attaches on the lateral part of the gluteus maximus. So you can palpate this. If you want to clarify if you are really on the gluteus maximus, you can ask person to extend the hip joint. Now gluteus maximus contracts, right? So this is how to make clarification. Gluteus maximus, iliac crest, and sacrum. Then gluteus maximus attaches on here, gluteal tuberosity, right here. It's very big muscle, very broad, fan-shaped muscle. So review, it originates from iliac crest, sacrum, coccyx, and some ligaments. That is sacrotuberous ligament. Then it attaches on gluteal tuberosity. So this is pretty much it. It's very easy to palpate gluteus maximus. This person wears the cotton pants. This is very hard material, but since this is very big muscle, it's no problem if person is wearing the cotton pants. So if you liked today's video, please like, comment, and subscribe. See you next video.